I'm just wiring up a shower pull cord in a bathroom, and so just for an electric shower, it's that one there. So just a couple of tips when you are wiring up a pull cord from new. Well, firstly, it's only about an 8.5 kilowatt shower, so I could have got away with 6 mil to an earth, but I always choose to put in 10 mil for a shower. So in the future, if they're going to upgrade the shower to anything bigger, you've already got the capacity in the cable. Again, yes, it does cost that little bit more, but it's not a massive cost. Yeah, so when you are prepping the cable, okay, I always like to leave plenty of flexibility or plenty of length on the cable. There's nothing worse than trying to come along and change one of these in the future and it's stuck up there in the corner, stuck up the pull cord's up there, and you've literally got no cable to work with. So always just leave a couple of foot spare cable. So hopefully you'll never have to change it. But if you have to, then at least when you drop it down, you've got all that space to work with. Secondly, when you are prepping the cable, what people sometimes do is they just cut all the wires off at the same length. The best tip I've got is cut the live and neutral off first, bend them round so they go into the terminals like so, and that then gives you plenty of spare on the earth or the CPC to come round and tuck it in nicely to the earth terminal, something like that. Okay, rather than cutting them all off nice and short and then it being a real tight. I see that all the time. You see a really bad, poor earth connection because the cable's just not long enough. So prep it in stages. Live and neutral first, get them done, leave a little bit extra length on the CPC, and then go from there. The next stage, I know this is obvious and simple, but I've just bent the cables round, okay, and then they're just going to tuck up into the terminals nice and easily, and so then hopefully it will look something like this. Basically, it means that you don't use much cable in there. It keeps everything nice and neat and tight in here. But if you ever do need to replace this pull cord for a different make or whatever it is, you've got all this extra length that you can use as spare. However, what I just want to show you on this one, so I've bent the cable round, and now you can see, because I've bent it round on this sort of radius here, some of the strands are now shorter than the others. So just get a pair of side cutters and cut them flush. That way they all go in nice and neat, they tuck in nice and neatly, and it's a good job. It's a good mechanical connection, therefore it'll give a good electrical connection. Okay, so now the pull cord is all wired up. Again, the CPCs, like I said earlier, they're a little bit longer, but now they loop around nice and neatly. They go into the earth terminal nice and neat. I haven't twisted the strands up, as you can see, but the reason for that is because the actual hole on the earth terminal is quite small. So if you twist them both up, it would be a struggle to get them both in. So I've laid them in side by side, and you can see that I have come through on either side. So there is a really good earth connection. One of the problems I often see on these is, like, for example, on the supply side, you might have a good CPC connection on the supply side, and then on the load side, the CPC has then come, or the earth has then come disconnected. Therefore, there is no earth at the shower. As you can see, that's really nice and neat terminations. Lastly, the pull cord is now fitted. The last thing to do, because I've been moving it around quite a lot, just go over the terminations and just double check that they are tight. Again, with these ones, I have double checked them a couple of times. Movement of pushing the cable back up can be, they're all quite tight. There you go. One thing to say, yes, it is a second hand pull cord. It's the same pull cord that was up there previously, but there's nothing wrong with it.